Gunlocks and Joyous rejoice because we got some great news. Hey guys, Nova Bushid here, welcome back to the channel, and today we're going to be talking about Kyle Slay's video on the Gunlocks. Now shout out to Game Cavalier, he's the one who sent me this in the Discord, so I really appreciate that guys. If you want me to react to stuff, you know, send it to me, let me know in the Discord or whatever memes, Twitter, and yeah, we can talk, we can chill, great stuff. So in Kyle Slay's video, he was using the Gunlocks and he had a Hunted Horn as well. And he used the Hunting Horn to actually buff his damage, and he noticed that the damage he was doing with his shells actually increased. So this led him to the conclusion, with some other testing as well, like his Palico also gave him a type boost, and that also seemed to buff his damage. It brought him to the conclusion that now shells actually scale with your weapon power, which is amazing. I mean, this is something that I've wanted for a while. You know, it's always kind of been, I've said this in previous episodes, it's always kind of been a struggling battle on how they should deal with shots and shot level and so on, because on one hand, yes, it's nice that you can just shoot wherever you want and just do the, you know, damage. You can shoot in a hard spot, you can break stuff easily, that's cool, that's great. But on the other hand, and in realistic Monster Hunter, there's not many hard spots on monsters. A lot of them have pretty good hitboxes in some regard, and normally the aim of the game is try to hit the weak spots. There's so many skills that Gunlocks loses out on because they can't benefit from it scaling off their base damage. You know, it can't crit, it can't do extra damage with attack, boost, or all these other abilities that we have in the game. Hunting Horn users don't really buff us up as much. All these buffs that we're drinking, they just don't get advantage of that. And on top of that, coming into Monster Hunter Wilds and the game focusing on weak spots and taking advantage of that, it just makes sense that now in this type of game, your shots also take advantage of that. Otherwise, it's just going to be you doing static damage on something that everyone else is getting increased damage on, which wouldn't make sense in this type of game, definitely with how they're pushing this focus mode and all that stuff. So this makes me really happy for Gunlocks. You know, I've been playing Gunlocks since 3U and I've loved it. I remember in Tri, there was this one Gunlocks in Tri where it was a lance, but it pretty much looked like a Gunlocks. And I was like, what is this weapon? But then 3U came and yeah, we had Gunlocks, but that's besides the point, sorry for that. This is great news, and I think it's just going to change the landscape for Gunlocks in general. The type of builds people are going to be building, the type of ways that we can be fighting. Gunlocks users are going to be focusing a lot more on positioning now than ever before. We got to be worrying about where we're hitting, and that might be a shift, a big shift in the gameplay comparison to how it used to be. Normally, I'm just going brrr.
What?
Normally, I'm just going crazy with my shots, pow pow, whenever I can, wherever I can, because you know I have the luxury to do that. But now I'm gonna have to be a bit more focused on where I'm hitting, and that's fine by me. You know, the game is supposed to be is built that way. The game is built around taking advantage of certain weak spots, so that's totally fine for me. Now, the second thing I want to talk about for the video is about Gunlocks in general. A lot of things he said about Gunlocks is that it feels very fluid. While in the older games, that wasn't always the case, but now in the newer games, they're definitely making it link more together for some weapons. For example, let's take the Short Shield and Longsword. Both weapons, you can kind of tell the moves lead into each other. Like, you can flow moves together, you can do flow your strings of moves. They flow together, right? But with Gunlocks, a lot of moves seem disjointed. Like, you can do certain stuff, but you can't lead into other stuff. And it's like, you go down one avenue, you're stuck in that avenue. While now, with more weapons, they're kind of linking the weapons together more, so it's an actual kit of a weapon. Yeah, it seems like the Gunlocks has a lot of ways to link moves into other moves, and that actually excites me a lot, because this is just going to make combat feel so much more fluid. Now, over the years, every game that Gunlocks has been in, they've slowly improved and improved and improved, going for old gen and even in the current gen. I mean, Gunlocks in World compared to Gunlocks in Rise and Sunbreak, I mean, they did a lot in Rise and Sunbreak to make it quite enjoyable for me, which was very nice, but there were still some issues, obviously. But now going into World, they're improving it again, and I like to see that. I like to see that continuous integration and improvements on weapons. It's really nice to see a weapon that you've been playing for a long time to really see that improvement as you go in further in the series. So I'm very excited for this one. I can't wait to see what Gunlocks has for us in this new game. Also guys, check out Kyle Slay's video. He went over many more points, such as it doesn't seem like shots actually take down sharpness, which is really cool. But you know, I want you to go check that out on his own video. I just wanted to cover these two topics. So yeah, I'm excited. Come on. But that's it for this video, guys. Let me know what you think down below. If you want to join the Discord, you know, links down below. If you want to follow me on Twitter, like the video, do all that. Do whatever you guys want to do. I appreciate it. But yeah, guys, hope you enjoyed the video. Let me know what you think down below, and I'll catch you guys next time. See ya.